God knows and he cares. Redeeming the Time Brothers podcast, a podcast by Gene Kissinger and Norman Kissinger, two brothers who have spent their lives in ministry and raising large families. Our desire is to provide a digital place for those who long to belong. And as always, we want to leave a nightlight on for you. That nightlight is out of Luke chapter 12. If you've been reading through the Gospel of Luke during the month of December, you'll read one chapter that corresponds with that date in the Bible. So today is the 12th, and we're reading Luke chapter 12. The two verses that I want to comment on and perhaps give a little devotional on are verse 7 and verse 27. Let me read 7 and 27. It says, "But even the very hairs of your head are all numbered. Fear not, therefore, ye are of more value than many sparrows." And then verse 27, "Consider the lilies, how they grow. They toil not, they spin not, and yet I say unto you that Solomon in all of his glory was not arrayed like one of these." I want you to know, there are two basic needs that humans have. One is to be known. We want the process of revealing ourselves to other people, who we really are to other people, and for them to know us for who we really are. There's a deep desire to get beyond the cliche level of communication. You know the cliche level. "Hey, how are you?" "I'm fine." You know, and we, "How's that weather?" "Boy, it was hot today." "How about those Broncos?" And we kind of talk in cliches back and forth. And that's fine for what it is. But there's a need in the human heart to go far beyond the cliche level, to reveal who we are, what we struggle with, what our strengths are, our emotional makeup, our personality traits, our intelligence, and really everything about us. Are we known? Does anybody know me? And the second great human need is care. It's not only that we need to reveal ourselves and be known by an intimate number of friends around us, we also need to know that we're cared about by those friends. In other words, if we were somehow absented from their lives, somehow we were withdrawn from their lives and we had to be somewhere else, we would want to know that we were missed, that we had provided some importance, an important element into their life, and their lives were made better because we were there. They care about us, and they would care if something happened to us. So care. Now, a lot of times we look for those two things exclusively in our human relationships, so that we try to go deep with other people and then they scurry away because they're uncomfortable with intimacy, or they give us we try to go in for a hug to make sure that they care about us, and they give us the awkward pat, 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 like, "Yeah, okay, we're hugging, but I'm not really into this. Get off of me," you know, and then it's easy to become jaded and go, "Well, nobody knows and nobody cares." And there are days that it's like that, but I want you to understand, first of all, more people know you than you realize, and more people care about you than you realize. It's just the exigencies of life sometimes pull us in so many different directions. We don't always properly express our love and care for the people that are around us. But let me give you a basic thing that I want you to understand. Even if nobody in the world cared about you, even if nobody in the world knows you, God does. And that is the most important principle you will ever come across. God knows you. How do you know that he knows you? Well, first of all, he knows the number of hairs on your head. Charles Spurgeon was talking to a man on his deathbed, and he asked the man, "Do you know Jesus?" And he said, "Yes, but that's not the source of my comfort. The source of my comfort is he knows me." That's a powerful thought. You and I one day are going to slip the surly bonds of earth and touch the face of God, stand in the presence of our Creator. And that Creator loves you enough to know the number of hairs on your head. That's an amazing, intimate knowledge. And this is not somehow a verse to display the technical knowledge of God. What he's doing is he's using the intimate nature of that knowledge to say God knows everything about you. He knows you're down sitting and you're uprising, Psalms 139. He knows the things you're good at, the things you're bad at. He considers your frame and he knows that you're dust. He knows you and he cares about you. But he knows you. He knows who you really are, and he loved you enough in your most vile moment, in the moment that you disappointed yourself and everybody else. In that moment, God loved you so much, he sent his son Jesus to die on the cross for you. That's amazing. That's an amazing grace. Do you understand that? That'll rock your world if you wrap your mind around. Here's a second thought. Let me get it really quickly. God cares. How do we know? Because he cares about the lilies of the field. He cares about the details of bringing an explosion of color in a rose. He knows how to make flowers that smell so good that they just seem like an explosion of joy. And if God cares about the flowers of the field, most of which human eyes might not even ever lay eyes on, they grow in the fields and in the mountains and they're never seen by humans, but God cares enough about them to give a splash of color or a special scent, that God that can clothe that lily and make it beautiful, more beautiful than Solomon, that God cares about you. That God sent his son to die on the cross for you. God knows you and God cares. I want you to hold on to that. When it seems like nobody else does, God does. Boy, please don't let that go. Please don't just skim over this. This is so important. In those moments when you're lonely, just say, thank you, God. Thank you for knowing me. Thank you for loving me in my worst. Thank you for helping me to bring out the best. Thank you. Thank you for being my God. Thank you for walking with me every moment of every day. You've been so good to me, God. Let's pray and thank God for knowing us and for caring about us. Dear Lord God, I thank you that you know the number of hairs on our head. You know the darkest secrets that are in our heart. You know the brightest moment of our lives. You know everything about us and you care about us. You care enough to send the very best, not a Hallmark card, but your son Jesus to die on the cross for us. What a good God you are. Lord, I just thank you for coming down to this soiled planet and living a sinless life and then dying on the cross for our sins. God, we don't deserve that, but we are so thankful for it. And God, forgive us for those times that somehow we've diminished that and went around saying nobody cares, nobody knows. You know, you care. And if that's the only audience we have, if that's the only friends we have, you're enough, God. We turn to you, we trust in you, we thank you. Lord, I just pray that you'd be with these dear ones under the sound of my voice. Give them a special sense of your presence. In Jesus' name, amen. Hey, God bless you guys. You have a great night. I love you, but God loves you, and that's the most important thing of all.